I'm here with Raphael Smith, the designer and creator of the Uber shelter behind us. Why is the Uber shelter called Uber shelter?
I was actually minoring in German at the time. The original design was one shelter stacked on top of the other. The idea was to cut down the overall size of a refugee camp to make it easier for aid agencies to distribute food, water, and medical attention. Since the design was a modular unit that stacked one on top of the other, the name Uber popped in my mind because Uber means above in German. So while I was trying to come up for a name, it came and it stuck. The design has changed quite a bit since the original concept, but we still maintain the idea of using vertical space for increased living area.
Where'd you get the initial design inspiration for this?
This project started as my undergraduate thesis in industrial design. I came across several articles that spoke about the terrible living conditions within relief camps, refugee camps. So this got me thinking that, you know, maybe the problem of shelter in disaster relief or in refugee camps could be a problem solved by design. And we started off with designs, CAD models, you know, a picture on a piece of paper. So to get the idea from paper to prototype was a huge step. I was fortunate enough to meet a man who is close to 40 years of experience in construction that really helped with finding the proper materials with, you know, when we were having troubles with stability or with how to construct things. His construction knowledge really played a large role in developing the prototype.
I'd spent like 10 years working on solving problems for emergency shelters, and my ideas were much heavier and much clunkier. And when I saw Raphael's, it really struck me that that's just, you know, that's much more the idea that needs to be there. And I really feel like the combination of our two abilities on the design aspect of this and solving the problems has really just created a synergy that's been very strong.
The shelter comes in a collapsed 4x8x2 package, which is shipped flat and delivered on site. From there, the shelter is unfolded and all the components that create the shelter are stored inside. The shelter is a two-story, three-room structure with two of the rooms being fully insulated. The second floor acts as a sleeping loft, which allows us to utilize vertical space for increased living area. One of the key features in our design is having an elevated floor, which is important for weather purposes. The floor rests on individual jack stands, which each one can be individually raised or lowered to allow the structure to remain level on uneven terrain. Creating a shelter that has the ability to adapt to different climates, different terrains, even different cultures is something that's what we're trying to address with this product.
What do I need in order to build the Uber shelter?
The Uber shelter is built with just a wrench and a ratchet. The shelter is delivered in a 4x8x2 package, and all the components that create the shelter are stored inside that collapsed package. The industrial design program at Purdue was great in assisting me to cover this topic, to do necessary research. The support from my professors, from other classmates, was huge. There are 42 million people displaced worldwide, and our mission is to better these lives through design. And I feel fortunate that I get to wake up every day and design products like this, and we feel that we're on the path to solving that problem with the Uber shelter.
With all the uncertainties in the world, Raphael and his team are on the right track to solving this urgent global problem. I'm Allison Douglas for Boiler Bytes.